Welcome to the South Florida Hospital News CEO video series. During the next few months, we will be conducting interviews with hospital and healthcare executives throughout the South Florida market. Today, we want to welcome Vedner Guerrier, the CEO of Memorial Hospital Miramar. Thank you for taking time out of your busy day today and joining us to learn a little bit more about your role at Memorial Miramar.
Thank you for having me.
Tell me a little bit about the position you're in now and when you started.
My current position, I am the administrator and chief executive for the Memorial Hospital Miramar. I started back in December of 2020. I recently transitioned into the role. I've been in the role for the last 5 months.
Tell me about your family background, Vedner.
I was born and raised in the Bahamas, and currently I'm married. I have a beautiful five-year-old about to turn six son, Ethan, my wife, Lorena, and we've been down here in South Florida, and it's been great.
What about educational background, Vedner? Where did you go to school, and how has that helped you with your career?
My high school, I attended the Mast Academy, which is the Maritime Academy of Science and Technology on Virginia Key, which is a magnet school focused on the maritime. But after I was done with high school, I had the opportunity to attend actually Miami-Dade College for the radiation oncology program. So I became a radiation and therapist. I have an associate's of science through Miami-Dade College. As I progressed in my career, I ended up going to Broward College and attained a bachelor's of science and supervision and management. After completing my bachelor's in supervision and management, I transferred to Florida International University, where I completed my MBA in healthcare.
People watching this want to know a little bit about your career background. We were discussing it a little bit earlier, but how you made this venture and where you started out to a CEO of Memorial Hospital Miramar.
I ended up getting a summer job working at Mount Sinai as a USA, which is a unit service assistant. So I had that opportunity to transport oncology patients to the oncology area at Mount Sinai, at which I befriended one of the engineers who introduced me to radiation therapy. So I signed up at Miami-Dade College, which had the radiation oncology program. Having completed that, I was hired at the Baptist Healthcare System for about a year. It was always a bidding warfare in healthcare for a radiation therapist. So I jumped from Baptist, I went to South Miami, and then I went to Mercy Hospital, all in about a three-year span. In June of 2001, I started working at Memorial as a radiation therapist. 3 years later, my supervisor who had brought me to Memorial left and went back to Mercy. We had a new administrator, Jeff Esham. I approached him and said, hey, I'm very much interested in leading becoming a chief therapist for the radiation program. So subsequently, chief therapist, a few years later, I became the manager of the radiation department. Then I had an opportunity to be the director over the oncology department. From there, I had an opportunity again to completely switch gears and transition to the Memorial Physician Group, the MPG, and work as an administrative director. 3 years of doing that, I was given the opportunity to take the vice president of oncology role. So I was assigned that role, and I returned back to the cancer center where I focused on moving the oncology program further. In that time, the position for Memorial Hospital Miramar became open for the CEO. I applied. Thankfully, I was selected, and that is my journey to how I became a CEO.
What does your typical day look like as CEO of Memorial these days?
I usually get in early. I'm an early riser. Review emails and make sure that we're ready to go for the day. We'll have our daily huddle in which we review, so to speak, what's the status of the house? How many patients do we have? And the most important thing from that meeting is the final question is, do you have everything that you need to be able to perform your job safely? We also really focus on, Are we addressing the needs for, say, COVID still being a primary area of concern for us? And how are we handling those cases? And once we do that, after that meeting's done, we have the opportunity to usually, with my chief nursing officer, Ms. Alberto Garcia, we'll go and round the unit.
Tell us a little bit about the mentor that stands out in your mind that kind of pushed you to where you are today.
I would say the mentor that really pushed me would be Jeff Esham. He was here. He was the administrator that had just joined the Memorial Healthcare System. He was the one that came out with the concept of institutes. He was the first one to coin, you know what? We have a cancer program, but we're more than just a program. We are the Memorial Cancer Institute. And he mentored me along the way in terms of when you're meeting, how to handle difficult conversations. I emulate a lot of how he's handled situations in my career, and it's been very fruitful.
Over the past year, we've all gone through the pandemic, COVID-19. What lessons lessons learned and new procedures that you're carrying forward that maybe you didn't do before?
I mean, COVID really went back to the fundamentals of me coming up as a leader. I truly learned to appreciate people now say essential workers, frontline heroes, but really the sacrifice that healthcare workers do on a daily basis, how important it is to make sure as a leader that I am supporting them every single day, because the challenges that they face at the bedside is so complex that you cannot undervalue that. I think that's the most important thing I took away from COVID. And that for me has been a lasting part of my development and my growth and my experience this past year, that I do not take for granted the special people that we have working in this organization and what they represent and what they do every single day.
As we kind of come to the end of this interview, a couple of more questions. A young person watching this, a young person meaning somebody just starting out in healthcare, maybe with an undergraduate or a graduate degree, what piece of advice would you give him or her to advance his career?
One, seek a mentor. Be open and willing to hear the words of wisdom that they will impart. Feel comfortable asking questions. And more importantly, explore. Really explore what are the opportunities. When the opportunity was presented to join the Memorial Physician Group, I was leaving oncology, an area that I had was very much comfortable with, 15 years experience by then, to go into an area of unknown where I had to go back. I had to start from scratch. I had to learn a variety of new services and different ways of working. And it's being, so to speak, open and allowing yourself, one, to be mentored. That's important, because you might have someone mentoring you and you don't want to receive the message being given. So allowing that goes a long way.
In your position, there's a lot to worry about. There's a lot going on every day, situations changing constantly. What keeps you up at night?
Have I provided my staff all of the resources they need to be successful? And when I mean successful, to be able to keep the safety of the patient, the quality of the care delivery, also their safety, their support. Am I providing enough resources for them? Are the appropriate resources? Am I asking the correct questions of them? Because, you go to someone, hey, how are you today? And everyone says, fine, I'm doing well. And being able to really make sure that I'm getting the responses and understanding what their needs are and that I am meeting those needs.
Well, Vedner, I appreciate your time today. I know you have a very busy day ahead of you. And I want to thank you for your support of South Florida Hospital News, and look forward soon to be able to come over and shake your hand.
And fantastic. You're welcome. We're here and always willing to support. And thank you for providing us a platform to educate others about the great things that we're doing here at Memorial Miramar.